pass does get him out here.
Auburn's final game of the 80s, the end of a decade, the beginning of an era, playing the Iron Bowl on campus instead of Legion Field in Birmingham. Pat Dye had set the wheels in motion at the start of the decade in a conversation with his former boss at Alabama.
That's the first thing Coach Bryant said to me when I saw him. When I came to Auburn in 81, he said, "You're going to want to take the game to Auburn." I said, "We're going to bring it to Auburn." He said, "Well, we got a contract through 88. I said, "We'll play 89 in Auburn."
8 years later, Pat Dye's prediction came true.
It just made sense for us to do it, and it was our home game. We could play it where we wanted to play it.
20 years later, images from the first ever are still fresh.
I still have a vivid memory of that week and that day. It was a big happening in Auburn, that's for sure.
It was a special day.
On that special day, David Housel served as Auburn's sports information director.
The Auburn people of today, those people who have become Auburn fans since 1989, they have no way of understanding, they have no way of appreciating what that day was like. And that's a good thing, because you never want to go back to the time where Auburn had to play its big games in Birmingham, where Auburn had to play Georgia Tech in Grant Field for 50 years, because we weren't big enough, strong enough, some people thought good enough to host our home game.
You can't tell people where they're going to play their home games. They will tell you where they're going to play their home games. That's just fair.
After waiting nearly a half century for this day, the day Alabama finally came to their campus, Auburn people were ready, beginning at Tiger Walk.
I mean, it was incredible.
When the players arrived at the stadium, more pandemonium. Quentin Riggins was one of Auburn's captains.
And the place was just crazy. The fans were crazy. And the noise was just deafening. And I could just, feel the energy in the crowd.
On the other side of the field, Bill Curry's Crimson Tide undefeated. Alabama's starting center was Roger Schultz.
You know, we went down there and 10-0 opportunity. You know, we think, we win this game. We finally beat Auburn after 3 years of losing to them. You know, we go play for the national championship.
I wanted so much for them to have that national title.
And, you know, we get down and it was so loud. I can remember the field shaking. It was so loud. And they had the pom-pom shaking. And they were made out of paper at that time, so it was like an orange and blue haze.
And kind of like an orange and blue haze from those old paper shakers.
On Auburn's opening drive, Reggie Slack connected with Alexander Wright for a big pass, setting the tone for Auburn's 30-20 win.
First of all, I want to make a presentation. I want to present Coach Dye with the game ball. Yeah!
The emotion that came from Coach Dye from the years of just trying to negotiate the game out of Birmingham and get it to Auburn, it meant more than the game.
If I'd been a little smarter, if I had prepared a little better, we would have. But Auburn was better than us that day, and they won the game.
It was equality as far as the Auburn football program. We had Auburn, we had Tennessee, we had Georgia, now Alabama coming to Auburn playing. And, you know, Coach Dye just let it all hang out to us.
Tonight's what our program's all about. I want you to think about it and let it sink in deep. This is the reason we work in the summertime in January and February and the spring. This is the reason we push you beyond what you think you can do to experience moments like this. Ain't no easy way in life, and it wasn't easy out there tonight, but you were prepared for the test.
Winning the game wasn't near as important as playing Alabama and Auburn. The score of the game, I mean, you're going to play a game every year, but it won't ever be but one first time. And that was big.